trading session. I think it's more or less flattish. Infosys yesterday delivered quite a googly in terms of TCS. What can we expect?
Well, you know, the expectations this time are a little more moderate than what we've seen in the past, because it appears that TCS has been a victim of its own past performance and therefore very high, you know, elevated expectations. So, you know, in fact, I was just seeing in Q2 of FY15, exactly a year ago, the poll for TCS's dollar revenue was 7.3%. So that's how high expectations were. And the company had come out and delivered a 6.5% revenue growth. And that was a disappointment. So this time, over the last, you know, few quarters, we've seen expectations also getting moderated. But that's how the performance of the stocks have been this entire year. TCS has been flat with a gain of close to about 1%. Infosys was at 15% yesterday. Now that's to come down to about 10 to 11 odd percent. So the key expectations are dollar revenue growth is seen higher by 3.6% on a quarter-on-quarter basis. But this will fall short compared to the 6% that Infosys delivered yesterday, which is better than street expectations. On the margin front, considering that we've seen the rupee depreciate in the prior quarter, because in IT you compare it on a quarter-on-quarter basis, in the prior quarter we had wage hikes, the absence of all that will boost their margins to 27%, and that flows through into the profitability, so profits are seen higher by close to about 6.5%. In terms of commentary, in the past, the company has spoken as Diligenta, which is its insurance BPO business, as a bit of a headwind area. In Latin America and Japan, they had these are the fringe markets for TCS, not the core markets. But over there, they had suffered a $20 million hit compared to prior expectations in the prior quarter. And they've always told us that energy will be soft, while telecom will be volatile, even as telecom delivered in the prior quarter. So these are a few headwinds area, whether the company maintains them or they expect an improvement. So that will be watched. But more importantly, this time we'll keep our eye out on some management commentary, which gives you a suggestion of the outlook for Q3 and Q4, because Infosys hinted at a subdued second half of the fiscal year, which is why that stock was under pressure. Some other things to keep your eye out on will be attrition. It's been rising for the last many quarters, and you want to see TCS deliver this time. This is a seasonally strong quarter. Expectations are not very high. Stock has been an underperformer, though it's a core holding. So you need to deliver an inline or a better set of earnings. That's what most people want to see in this quarter, considering Infosys managed to do so well in this quarter.
All right, Reema, thanks so much for joining and giving us all those details. We'll be waiting by for that set of numbers. But let's talk about macros then. We have with us Anubhuti Sahai, the senior.